Okay, how are you all? Are you fine? Yes. So, in the last video, we have learned about the motion and its rays. Today, we are going to learn the types of motion. Today, we are going to discuss about the types of motion. So, in a short, I will tell you what things we are going to learn in this video. Types of motion: translatory, rectilinear, curvilinear, circular, rotatory, oscillatory, vibratory, periodic, non-periodic, random, compound. Compound motion is also called as a multiple motions. Okay, today we are going to discuss this all the points. In the last video we have learned about the motion and rest, and we have also discussed about the Newton's law of motion. I hope you have understood that all this. So today we are going to discuss about the types of motion. So first is translatory. Translatory. Trans means what? Translatory means what? The motion which are moving in a straight line. The object which moves in a straight line in a particular time. So that motion is called as a translatory motion. They are also classified into two types, that is uniform, linear. See, in the words only, all this, whatever the types of motions are there, in that words only the definition is hidden. So you have to just explain them. So translatory means the object which moves in a straight line. So that is called as a translatory. Now uniform, linear motion. Uniform means same distance, the object that moves at the same distance and at the same time. So that motion is called as a uniform linear motion. Non-uniform linear means what? When an object is moving in a straight line but at a different interval of a time. For example, if when you are coming from the slide, at that time your speed is little bit slow, and once you come down your speed is increasing. So that is the non-uniform linear motion. Then in the translatory, the motions are classified into two types: rectilinear and curvilinear. Rectilinear means what? The object which moves in a straight line. For example, see, when you are on the torch, at that time what happens? The light moves in a straight line. So that is a rectilinear motion. Next is curvilinear. When an object is moving in a straight line but it takes a curved path. It moves in a curved path. For example, see, when you are traveling in a car section, at that time the car is moving in a straight line but it is taking some curved path. So that is called as a curvilinear motion. In the word only, all the definitions are there. Then next is circular motion. I hope you have understood about translatory, rectilinear and curvilinear. So next is circular motion. Circular motion means what? The object which moves in a circular path. The object is moving in a circular path. So for example, the hands of the clock, they are moving in a circular path. So it is an example of a circular motion. Merry-go-round. In a garden, you might have seen the merry-go-round. It is moving in a circular path. So that motion is called as a circular motion. Next is rotatory. Now rotatory motion means what? The when an object moves along a fixed axis, that is called as a rotatory motion. For example, the blades of a fan, they are moving in a fixed axis. It has a fixed axis, so that comes under the rotatory motion. Spinning of a top. The next example is the spinning of a top. The best example is rotation of an earth. Am I right? So rotation of the earth, it comes under the rotatory motion. The next is oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion means what? Now, have you visited your garden? Yes. So have you seen the swing? Yes, it is moving forward and backward, forward and backward, am I right? So that is nothing but the oscillatory motion. The motion which moves, the object which moves to and fro, that motion is called as a oscillatory motion. That motion is called as a oscillatory motion. Next is vibratory. Vibratory means what? When it gets vibrated, an object gets vibrated, that motion is called as a vibratory motion. See, all the musical instrument comes under the example of the vibratory motion. Your mobile phone also gets vibrated, right? So it is the vibratory motion. The next is periodic motion. See, periodic motion means what? Which repeat after a equal interval of time. For example, the day and night, it occurs at the equal interval of a time. So that is the example of periodic motion. Pumping of your heartbeats, it is also example of a periodic motion. Non-periodic motion means what? The object which does not repeat, the motion which does not repeat after an equal interval of a time, so that is called as a non-periodic motion. For example, all the natural calamities, we can say they are the example of the non-periodic motion. Next is random motion. The random motion means the object which moves randomly in any direction. So that motion is called as a random motion. For example, see, the butterfly flies every time, anyhow. We can't tell that it will travel in a straight direction, it will move in the left direction, it will move in the right direction. It is moving anyhow. The birds, they are moving in anyhow. We can't tell that they will move today in this direction, they will move in that direction. So it is a example of a random motion. Then last example, last type of the motion is compound motion, or it is also called as a multiple motion. Means what? When an object possesses two or more motion together, when an object is performing the two and more motions together, so that motion is called as a compound motion, or it is also called as a multiple motion. For example, see, rotation of an earth. See, earth also rotate and also revolve around the sun. So it is performing the both the tasks. So that comes under the compound or a multiple motion. When you are cycling, at that time, see, the wheels of the bicycle, what happened? It is moving in a circular path, also it is moving forward. So it comes under the compound or a multiple motions. Have you understood the types of motion? I will just recall all the types of motion in a short. What we have discussed? Translatory. In that we have discussed about uniform and non-uniform linear motion, rectilinear, curvilinear, circular, moving circular path, rotatory, fixed axis, oscillatory, to and fro, vibratory, which gets vibrated, periodic, repeat after equal interval of time, non-periodic, does not repeat after equal interval of a time, random, moves in any direction, compound or multiple, possesses two or more motions together. So this we have discussed. So today's work will be, listen carefully, today's work will be, whatever the motions we have discussed, at least write 5 example of each. Means suppose if you will take circular motion, you have to write the 5 example. 5 example of circular, rotatory, oscillatory, vibratory, periodic, non-periodic, random, compound. At least write the 5 example of each. Okay, thank you everyone.